Hello friends, welcome to the Commerce Achiever platform. In this platform, we are going to cover all the subjects related to commerce and management, and we'll give you different courses. For that, please visit our website on www.commerceachiever.com. To get an expertise knowledge, please subscribe our channel and click the bell icon to get the latest notifications of the videos uploaded. So through this video, we are going to cover the next point of the taxation, and we are doing income tax. We already understood the topic assessment year and previous year. We already covered when newly set up business or profession is started, what to do, how to identify the previous year in case of new business or profession. We already discussed in the previous video that what is the previous year in case of income is undisclosed. Okay, if the income is undisclosed or investment is undisclosed or any valuable is undisclosed. We already discussed three main points in the previous videos. Kindly go through those videos. Okay, now through this video, we will discuss the third and the last point related to assessment year and previous year is like certain income the previous year in which it is incurred taxable in the same previous year. Okay, so assessed in the previous year itself, it will be assessed in the same previous year itself. Okay, so let's see in detail. General rule, what is the general rule of the taxability? The general rule is the previous year, the year in which income is earned. Okay, and assessment year is the following year or succeeding year, okay, of the income. This means the year in which income is taxable. Okay, this is the basic rule, it's the general rule of income tax, but there are a few exceptions which we are going to learn in this video. Okay, the first exception, okay, the first exception is shipping business of whom? Shipping business of non-resident, NR. Okay, I'm using the shortcut, section falls under section 172. Okay, then the second exception is person leaving India falls under section 174. Okay, then third exception is association of persons, body of individual or artificial judicial persons that formed for particular purpose. Okay, that formed for particular purpose or event, and that purpose or event is established or supposed to be established in a very near period. Okay, so it falls under section 174A. Okay, and the fourth is when it is on the viewpoint of an assessing officer that the person is likely to transfer, likely there is a possibility to transfer the property to avoid tax. Okay, transfer the property to avoid tax, just to avoid the tax, the person either selling or giving on a lease to avoid the taxation, fall under section 175. And the last, the fifth one, is discontinued business, when the business will going to be discontinued due to any of the reasons. Okay, discontinued business, it falls under section 176. Okay, so let's see in detail each and every point. Okay, the first we already discussed a shipping business, I'm using the shortcut. Okay, shipping business, section 172. So what the main points we have to look is where it is a ship should be belongs to the non-resident. Okay, it should belong to the non-resident. What it carry? It carry anything, either it carry a passenger, it carry a livestock, okay, it carry a goods, anything it carry. There is a no specific requirement that it should carry a one specific, it carry anything. Okay, it should belong to the non-resident and it carry anything, okay, either mail or livestock or even the passenger. Okay, so ship is allowed to leave the port. The ship is standing in the Indian port, and it's allowed to leave that port only when it is allowed to, either the tax has been paid, already paid the tax, or made an arrangement, a satisfactory arrangement. On whose eyes the satisfactory? On the eyes of the assessing officer. A satisfactory arrangement has been made. These four points should be in your brain. Okay, an arrangement has been made, then what will do? AO will do what? It will calculate the tax. Okay, how, what will be the amount of tax? It will be the 7.5% of freight paid or payable. Okay, ठीक है, paid or payable by holder, जिसने भी whoever hold the ships or a carriage, okay, by any person who is holding the ships, say, ठीक है, to any person may be, it may be an owner or on his owner behalf, anybody or an any agent, anybody, ठीक है, there is a no criteria that it should be paid to the owner, ठीक है, and where the payment has been made, whether the payment has been made in India or outside India, there is no criteria that it should be paid in India only, ठीक है, either it's paid in India or outside in India on account of such carriage, okay, then it will be treated as in deemed income of an SSE, 7.5% deemed income of the SSE, and that will be charged to tax in the charged, when it is charged to tax, it will be charged to tax in the same year in which it is earned. It is earned. I hope it is clear. Okay. So you have to just recall these main points, that it should belong to the NR, it should carry anything, it should be standing on the Indian port, it should pay or make an arrangement for the payer. Then what will be taxable? What amount will be? It will be the 7.5%. Either it is paid to any person, okay? Payment either in India or outside India. There is no specific criteria. Okay? It will be treated as in deemed income and starts to tax in the same year in which it is earned, okay? The second most important point is person living in India. Where it is seen that person is living in India either in the same previous year or in a very near time of the next previous year, okay? And person is living in India. Okay, and there is an in the view of the AO that the person has no possibility to get back to India. Okay, fall under section 174. Okay, AO think that individual may leave, okay, during current assessment year or very shortly time. Okay, and there is a no intention shows that of the person that it will return to India. Okay, then the total income of an individual for the period from the expiry of previous year. Suppose the previous year expire on 2018. March, okay, so from 1st April 2018 till date, till the probable date of departure, okay, whatever the probable date an AO finds, the probable date of departure, okay, will be taken as an period for calculation of an income, and that will be chargeable to tax in the, say, in that assessment year itself, okay. Next, the third point, I told you that AOP or BOI or artificial judicial person who formed for the purpose of specific purpose or an event, and that purpose or an event has been accomplished or to be accomplished in a very near time, and if the purpose is established, AOP will be dissolved, okay, either in the near time or in the next year, then what we will do, the assessment has to be made from the last previous year, same as the case of two, from the last previous year till the date of dissolution. It's very easy. Now all points are very easily. Okay? And it will be taxable in that assessment year only. Okay. That same assessment year. Next. The fourth point I talk to you about the when the person transfers property. Okay. To avoid tax. Transfer property to avoid tax. Okay. To avoid tax, that will fall under section 175, okay, or it likely to charge it off or sell it off, okay, with any office to avoid the payment under the income tax act, okay, then the total income of the person from that previous year, okay, till the expiry of the previous year to the date the AO thinks fit, okay, like the previous year, suppose any previous year end last year, then the previous year after that closer till the say on the AO starts what assessment, okay, till that date, it's depend on an AO, okay, the duration it will take, okay, and the last case will be the discontinued business, that is section 176. In case of any kind of business or profession is discontinued, okay, and the income, how will we calculate the income? The previous year, the closure of last previous year up to the date of discontinuance, it will be same. It is on the discretion of an assessing officer how the AO will calculate, okay, then closure of last previous year to discontinuation period, okay, will be charged as in tax in the same assessment. I hope all the 4-5 points, only the first point is quite different, last 4 point are the same. Okay, so I hope all the concepts are clear. In case of any doubt, feel free to ask in a comment section. And it's now through these videos I'm giving you an explanation of the income tax. Okay, and in the after some time with the near future, we will provide you the discussion. Okay, live discussions. Okay, discussions, or we can say a revision. We can say the revision videos. In that, we will straight away take care of the only provisions, because what the taxation is required is understanding plus provision should be in your brain. Why these two are equally important is because if you won't understand, you won't able to deal with the different criteria of the questions came into an exam. And provisions is important to understand. It's because you cannot use the lay languages. You have to be out of the box. So it's important to use the laws, the legal words. Okay. So for that, the provision is very important. So both portion is very equally likely important. Okay. So in the near future, we will straight away read the provision for you, so that you can just hear that provision, and while going to the bed or awakening or on the way of your routes, just listen to the provision and keep memorizing those provisions so that you give your best during the examination. Okay, in case of any doubt, feel free to ask in the comment section. You can also join us on a Telegram or on a Facebook page. And to get in more information about the courses, please visit our Commerce Achiever website, www.commerceachiever.com. So stay connected with us for a quality knowledge. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat. Hello friends, welcome to the Commerce Achiever platform. In this platform, we are going to cover all the subjects related to commerce and management, and we'll give you different courses. For that, please visit our website on www.commerceachiever.com. To get an expertise knowledge, please subscribe our channel and click the bell icon to get the latest notifications of the videos uploaded. So through this video, we are going to cover the next point of the taxation, and we are doing income tax. We already understood the topic assessment year and previous year. We already covered when newly set up business or profession in started, what to do, how to identify the previous year in case of new business or profession. We already discussed in the previous video that what is the previous year in case of income is undisclosed. Okay, if the income is undisclosed or investment is undisclosed or any valuable is undisclosed. We already discussed three main points in the previous videos. Kindly go through those videos. Okay, now through this video, we will discuss the third and the last point related to assessment year and previous year is like certain income or the previous year in which it is incurred taxable in the same previous year. Okay, so assessed in the previous year itself, it will be assessed in the same previous year itself. Okay, so let's see in detail. General rule, what is the general rule of the taxability? The general rule is the previous year, the year in which income is earned. Okay, and assessment year is the following year or succeeding year, okay, of the income. This means the year in which income is taxable. Okay, this is the basic rule. It's the general rule of income tax, but there are few exceptions which we are going to learn in this video. Okay, the first exception, okay, the first exception is shipping business. Shipping business of whom? Shipping business of non-resident, NR. Okay, I'm using the shortcut. Section falls under section 172. Okay, then the second exception is person leaving India. Person leaving India falls under section 174. Okay, then third exception is association of persons, body of individual or artificial judicial persons that formed for particular purpose. Okay, that formed for particular purpose or event, and that purpose or event is established or supposed to be established in a very near period. Okay, so it falls under section 174A. Okay, and the fourth is when it is on the viewpoint of an assessing officer that the person is likely to transfer, likely there is a possibility to transfer the property to avoid tax. Okay, transfer the property to avoid tax. Just to avoid the tax, the person either selling or giving on a lease to avoid the taxation, fall under section 175. And the last, the fifth one, is discontinued business, when the business will going to be discontinued due to any of the reasons. Okay, discontinued business, it falls under section 176. Okay, so let's see in detail each and every point. Okay, the first we already discussed a shipping business. I'm using the shortcut. Okay, shipping business, section 172. So what the main points we have to look is where it is a ship. Ship should be belongs to the non-resident. Okay, it should belong to the non-resident. What it carry? It carry anything. Either it carry a passenger, it carry a livestock, okay, it carry a goods, anything it carry. There is a no specific requirement that it should carry a one specific. It carry anything. Okay, it should belong to the non-resident and it carry anything. Okay, either mail or livestock or even the passenger. Okay. So ship is allowed to leave the port. The ship is standing in the Indian port. Standing in the Indian port. And it's allowed to leave that port only when it is allowed to, either the tax has been paid, already paid the tax, or made an arrangement, a satisfactory arrangement. On whose eyes the satisfactory? On the eyes of the assessing officer. A satisfactory arrangement has been made. These 4 points should be in your brain. Okay. An arrangement has been made, then what will do? AO will do what? It will calculate the tax. Okay, how, what will be the amount of tax? It will be the 7.5% of freight paid or payable. Okay, okay, paid or payable by holder, jisne bhi, whoever hold the ships or a carriage. Okay, by any person who is holding the ships, say, okay, to any person. Any person may be, it may be an owner or on his owner behalf, anybody, or in any agent, anybody. Okay, there is a no criteria that it should be paid to the owner. Okay, and where the payment has been made, whether the payment has been made in India or outside India, there is no criteria that it should be paid in India only. Okay, either it's paid in India or outside and India on account of such carriers. Okay, then it will be treated as in deemed income of an SSE. 7.5% deemed income of the SSE, and that will be charged to tax in the charged, when it is charged to tax, it will be charged to tax in the same year in which it is earned. It is earned. I hope it is clear. Okay, so you have to just recall these main points, that it should belong to the NR, it should carry anything, it should be standing on the Indian port, it should pay or make an arrangement for the payer. Then what will be taxable? What amount will be? It will be the 7.5%. Either it is paid to any person, okay? Payment either in India or outside India, there is no specific criteria. Okay? It will be treated as a deemed income and charged to tax in the same year in which it is earned, okay? The second most important point is person living in India. Where it is seen that person is living in India either in the same previous year or in a very near time of the next previous year, okay? And person is leaving India, okay? And there is an in the view of the AO that the person has no possibility to get back to India, okay? Fall under section 174, okay? AO think that individual may leave, okay, during current assessment year or very shortly time, okay? And there is a no intention shows that of the person that it will return to India, okay? Then the total income of an individual for the period from the expiry of previous year, suppose the previous year expire on 2018 March, okay? So from 1st April 2018 till date, till the probable date of departure, okay, whatever the probable date an AO finds, the probable date of departure, okay, will be taken as an period for calculation of an income, and that will be chargeable to tax in the, say, in that assessment year itself. Okay, next, the third point, I told you that AOP or BOI or artificial judicial person who formed for the purpose of specific purpose or an event, and that purpose or an event has been accomplished or to be accomplished in a very near time, And if the purpose is established, AOP will be dissolved, okay, either in the near time or in the next year. Then what we will do, the assessment has to be made from the last previous year, same as the case of 2, from the last previous year till the date of dissolution. It's very easy. Now all points are very easily, okay, and it will be taxable in that assessment year only, okay, that same assessment year. Next, the fourth point I talk you about, the when the person transfers property, okay, to avoid tax, transfer property to avoid tax, okay, to avoid tax, that will fall under section 175, okay, or it likely to charge it off or sell it off, okay, with any office to avoid the payment under the income tax act, okay. Then the total income of the person from that previous year, okay, till the expiry of the previous year to the date the AO thinks fit, okay. Like the previous year, suppose any previous year and last year, then the previous year after that closer till the, say on the AO starts, AO starts what? Assessment, okay? Till that date. It's depend on an AO, okay? The duration it will take, okay? And the last case will be the discontinued business, that is section 176. In case of any kind of business or profession is discontinued, okay? And the income, how will we calculate the income? The previous year, the closure of last previous year up to the date of discontinuance, it will be same. It is on the discretion of an assessing officer how the AO will calculate, okay? Then closure of last previous year to discontinuation period, okay? Discontinuation period, okay? Will be charged as in tax in the same assessment. I hope all the 4-5 points, only the first point is quite different. Last 4 points are the same, okay? So I hope all the concepts are clear. In case of any doubt, feel free to ask in a comment section. And it's now through these videos I'm giving you an explanation of the income tax, okay? And in the after some time with the near future, we will provide you the discussion, okay? Live discussions, okay? Discussions, or we can say a revision, we can say the revision videos. In that we will straight away take care of the only provisions, because what the taxation is required is understanding plus provision should be in your brain. Why these two are equally important is because if you won't understand, you won't able to deal with the different criteria of the questions came into an exam. And provisions is important to understand, it's because you cannot use the lay languages, you have to be out of the box. So it's important to use the laws, the legal words, okay? So for that the provision is very important. So both portion is very equally likely important, okay? So in the near future we will straight away read the provision for you, so that you can just hear that provision, and while going to the bed or awakening or on the way of your routes, just listen to the provision and keep memorizing those provisions so that you give your best during the examination, okay? In case of any doubt, feel free to ask in the comment section. You can also join us on a Telegram or on a Facebook page. And to get in more information about the courses, please visit our Commerce Achiever website, www.commerceachiever.com. So stay connected with us for quality knowledge. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.